nice, bro. Nice. Keep it up. Let's keep your left hand out and use your forehead, bro.
I love my kids. Some have been with me since kindergarten. More than playing tennis, I invest into their lives, emphasizing balance in body, soul, and spirit. There were times in the past when my drive to push them toward excellence didn't come from a good place. Growing up, tennis was my life. It was always about self-control and discipline. I was driven to accomplish what I set out to achieve. There came a time when my life began to fall apart with circumstances beyond my control. Drowning in anguish, unable to see the light, I sank into the deep hole of depression. I tried to kill myself. In the deepest and darkest moment, I cried out, "God, I'm done with this life. Take it. Do what you want with it." This became the turning point in my walk with God. No more chasing after trophies and accolades to my faith, but reaching out the truth instead. God led me through a miraculous journey of healing. No more depression. No more pills. I'm so sorry. I love you, but I love God, and I cannot walk down this path with you. I still remember the line that started this whole roller coaster journey to freedom and healing. My heart was broken, shattered. I had given up my life in the US to come back to Singapore to be with the woman I love. Devastated and confused. This was the same highly intelligent and successful woman who I've admired since I was 8 and pursued halfway around the world. I've not been a loser to some God of the Bible. This Christian God became a competitor. I researched extensively to disprove Christianity. I was aggressive and argumentative. I made life hell for my friend. What baffled me was that she would never retaliate. Her responses were always loving. She was patient and kind, always gentle, and never rude. Every time I would ask them, so, how can you just accept what the Bible says? She went the distance to discuss truth with me. I have done and said terribly cruel and hurtful things to her. Yet she endured them, forgave me, and continued to be my friend. Through my discourse with her and my own research, I was convinced of the truth of Jesus Christ. I became a believer in 2006. It wasn't faith, but logical thinking. It took another 7 long years before my good knowledge of Jesus sunk into my heart as I encountered His pure and perfect love. God's love changed my whole perspective on what true love is. I used to think that love equals sexual intimacy, but now I know that the freedom to love is not the same as the freedom to have sex. Jesus Christ is the epitome of love without sex. My friend exercised her freedom to love. To love me with the love of Christ. Love does not equal sexual intimacy. True love embraces and protects the sanctity of God's original design of the human body. I believe, as human beings, made up of body, soul, and spirit, the deepest connection between two people is spiritual intimacy. Jonathan and David exemplified this in the Bible. Because of Jesus, because of love, the once painful, love-hate relationship with my friend has become a beautiful friendship filled with love, joy, peace, and a depth of spiritual intimacy I never imagined possible. That's what true love does. That's what true love is.